Samaya Manopalaya Turn the camera off. That's what they do. They just sit and work into the mind. Just breathe. The pasana. Just focus on it. And then. So what's going to happen when it is
let's make a circle, not an egg.
This is a weird circle. Look at you.
The people down there, if they want to join a circle.
I don't want to use it. I'm done.
He wants a real circle. Yeah. This arc is not making it.
And I'm with one.
Okay. I guess it's good enough. I'm going to attach to the circle.
Yeah. Now we begin to question and answer. Do you have anything that you'd like to share to the retreat? Any questions? We begin with Marcus. We can go around here.
I have a question. The seven, there weren't precepts, the seven things this morning.
Practice.
Right, the seven practices. Can you repeat them just by name?
Okay, let me read it. The first is mindfulness. The second is the investigation of Dharma phenomena. The third is diligence.
Diligence.
For joy, the fifth is ease, the sixth is concentration, the seventh is let go.
What's the difference between diligence and concentration?
Diligence is like you put more effort to your practice. Concentration is more calm to the point as oneness. You focus on one. So diligence is like, for example, my hand, right? Diligence is like you want to grab something. And concentration is when you hook on whatever you're grabbing. Instead of grabbing the watch, whatever, just grab one thing.
So it's focus versus effort.
I have enjoyed it very much, and it's helped me to realize that for a while there I was getting upset every time I turned around until I caught myself. I thought, Cheryl, what are you doing? This is life. It's supposed to be precious. It's supposed to be enjoyed. It's supposed to be, you know, enjoy the moment and then let it go. So that's what I'm trying to practice, and I need to tell you today. I want it.
Gratitude. I felt, you know, I felt very emotional, a point like of tears.
Emotional?
Very emotional. I felt all the emotions because I did feel the anger. The anger came with snoring. I don't know what snoring means.
But I was following that snoring, so and I kept on getting mad, and I'm like, I'm not supposed to be following that, you know? And so I get the anger, I got the gratitude of actually the gratitude to experience this. Each and one of us made it possible, because you say we have to be 15 people. And we were more than 15 people, so it was possible for them, for it to happen. So that I was grateful. And I learned something which I know, like I try and practice a lot of things in my life to know that it's bigger than me. You know, I try and work out because I know like I'm working out for the world, you know? So, but today I forgot until you mentioned it, and you say, because I made it my meditation is to give it away, you know? And it was a little bit frustrating because I was thinking maybe I should think of people like, and who I'm giving it to, and then I was just relax. If I just give it, then I don't have to actually mention names or think of, you know, if it comes, person's face comes up, then I want to be able to give it, but I don't want to think selfishly that I want to give it to my family and start imagining each one member of my family. So that was that. But thank you to all. Thank you so much. Yes.
Between mending is just again and again, the thought, fear, gratitude, and worry about what other people need.
I'm also very have gratitude that I was able to participate in it, and I mean, especially like the small discussion that we had and the advice of how the transformation happens at the present. I think I take that with me. So.
This is my first retreat here, and I was fortunate to have found you guys. I moved here from Kentucky. Back and I said with the group there, and I'm so appreciative of all of you and practice with you so much.
I'm very grateful that I got a chance to come here this weekend. I was supposed to go to here for work, but I actually canceled it. But I'm going to this one. So it really, you know, being in a class like this really helps me to be able to center myself and meditate, because I'm one of those that can't sit still for 10 minutes. I sit still, meditate, and I have to get up and move around. But coming here, my thoughts didn't actually slow down until midday. So it took that long for me to be centered. So I'm learning, still learning a lot, and I want to continue to learn. So hopefully more opportunities to come to this these retreats.
This now, for some reason, the monkey mind wasn't bothering me too much with my meditation today. I was able to keep away from me. So that's something I didn't have. Usually for a long time before I even get it. It was easy. I'm not behind this.
Enjoying the simple.
So today I had to let go of what I couldn't do and just say this is what I can do, and that's what I'm going to do today. And so that was a good lesson. And the other was, I'm very grateful for all the people who helped me today with chairs and walking in.
So
is hard for me because my research is limited. But I enjoyed a lot, especially that when Tim is teaching us how to do the yoga stretches, the exercise. But please, the next half, please do slowly.
And that a lady cooking, a cooking lady.
I miss toys already for retreat, but because I'm in the kitchen to help cook Japanese.
The food we eat, see, cooking?
Yeah,
thank you. Yeah,
The rule is from now on is if you join a retreat, you don't cook. Join the retreat. How would you
do
it? Yeah, don't worry. You can always figure that out.
Okay. I
didn't
come here forever, but I
any comment, question?
Yeah, I think you're accepting me today. I think it worked, so, but I did want to come, so sorry I missed it, but maybe next time. Thank you.
Well, with meditation, I've learned a lot. In the past, meditation, body pain, and the breathing really helps you now. Start breathing from down here and fall through. So pain's not a problem anymore, but clearing the mind is the next step for me. So basically what I do now is when I'm trying to meditate and there's so much going around in my head, I just chant, and that helps a lot.
A big chant?
Not more than even five. I just said it over and over and over in my head.
Mantra.
It helps. I got one more question. When we're meditating, you walk around with a big stick. What's the purpose of a stick? Is that tradition?
Yeah. It's called a winking stick.
It scares me. It's like you're taking a final exam and you're the professor and you're messing up.
That's why we call a winking stick. Tell you to awaken.
It's a winking stick.
When he walks around, if someone is falling asleep, right?
Oh, then you whack him.
Yeah, so what he does is he comes and touches you on the right shoulder. You turn your head. He taps here. There's a nerve here. Mm-hmm. When you tap that nerve, it wakes up your brain.
Oh.
Wakes up the mind. Just a slight tap. No, it's not a chop.
You need a smaller stick.
When you spend down after what you do it, you can see who you can see.
I'll go to eBay and find one.
Okay, next.
What was the chant that he was talking about? What is it called?
Namo Ajira Padme Nam. That is recite the Buddha name. Clearly Buddha.
Oh, okay.
Or you can recite Kate Para Kate Parasankate Bodhisattva.
Oh, okay.
Whatever you want.
Well, I'm really grateful to be here and to be a student in this environment and to be learning from each and every one of you. It's been a blessing, and meditation really helps with easing my worries, and I tend to be an overthinker, so kind of just learning to calm the mind has really helped me find peace, so thank you so much.
you're a runner, so that's a good time, because you may, especially if you're training for a marathon, you're out there for several hours, that's a good place to focus, to practice your meditation. So focus on the breath, or even your step, your stride,
okay.
Right? And try to relax the body. And any pain that comes up, any sensation comes up, watch that, let it go away. Just observe and continue to cycle through that process.
So running meditation too, you can run and meditate.
Oh, okay.
You can do some running meditation.
Can you clear your mind?
So many people dedicated to living the Buddha life, and they are dedicated to practicing the Buddha life.
Sean?
Well, thank you for this opportunity. It was great. It was the first time I actually went to a retreat, and it's a time for me to do all the things that I know I should be doing and make a bigger commitment to regular practice and making more progress. I feel like I'm getting into the groove. So thank you for this place and the opportunity to practice it.
Do it without judgment, right?
I'm grateful also. Thank you for hosting this second retreat. I enjoy every moment. Sometimes the yoga is painful. it was enlightening.
Having this retreat that gives me a chance to get away from all those iPhones, iPads, distractions, and just concentrate on myself.
And your wife too.
As far as you go, I sent her down the kitchen. That's my wife. But also coming here by doing that and coming to this retreat, I'm able to do my meditation and I'm able to bring back my senses, in other words, my sensitivity to things around me. That a lot of times I ignore, I just don't realize they're there until I come here, and then, like I say, don't have distractions and stuff, and I can actually feel or sense different things that are out there, but on a daily basis, I don't feel them. So I appreciate that. Thank you.
So more practice on the daily, more of the daily practice. Because that's what's going to help you. You know, you only do retreat once, you know, in a while, right? So, but the daily practice is much more important.
Well, thank you. My name is Jennifer. I'm from
I just wanted to say thank you for sharing all the wisdom, and thank you for the Sangha. You know, it's always, I don't know what it is about meditating with a group that's always better. It's always nice to see new faces here too, so that's always nice. I really appreciated the focus of the class, giving a chance to focus on impermanence and letting things go. I think one thing I've been struggling with that I kind of made some ground on today was that it seems like I'm always trying to make sense of everything and try to find meaning, and it's almost like I want to see a diagram of how all this ideas work together and how one part fits in, and you know, like I realize that I have to let that go, that's not important, and that maybe there isn't meaning, and I just need to experience it for what it is rather than try to, you know, see it as a diagram or see how it all works and struggle to try to understand and just realize that it'll happen and be patient, I guess. That's what we kind of discovered today, so thank you.
Yeah, the workshop will show you the diagram so that you can forget it. Free coaching.
Again, just kind of reiterate what everybody's saying. I'm just extremely grateful to be here today for the opportunity to practice. It's really hard to verbalize what I experienced here today, but I think there's just a sense of we were all able to experience something that was meaningful to each and every one of us. And I definitely am taking some learned experience away from me from today with me, so I'm extremely grateful for you very much.
Yeah, just thank you, and it's wonderful to know this community is here, and there are so many different things that happened today, the food and the teaching, the yoga, and meeting you guys, so it was really good.
That's word. That's word. Well, congratulations for being quiet for a whole day like that. I know it's really difficult. I know there are people out there that rather get electric shock than being silent and look within their mind. So it is a challenge, especially in this day and age. And with all the attachments distraction that we have out there, really appreciate everyone being here and practicing, because you're not only practicing for yourself. When we practice for the world. Don't think about the big picture, I need to save the world. The way you save the world is to save yourself first. Have compassion for yourself. Manifest that compassion within. Because if you don't have that compassion for yourself, you have no capacity for compassion for others. Because you won't be able to accept differences, right? Different thoughts, different perspectives. So we practice, yes, we practice for ourselves, but we practice without selfishness.